Hi all, welcome to our channel. Hope you all are doing good. So guys, you know, after a long time we are just going to bring up this video. So where there are one of our viewer has requested to differentiate between custodian, depository and clearing house. So today we'll discuss on that. So custodian, depository and a clearing house. So all these terms, like all are very big terms in terms of trading, but we'll discuss in very short how they are like going to be utilized and why they are called so. So the very first one, custodian. If you take this, the name itself says, right, custodian. So something, they are going to act as a custodian for anyone. So what kind of custody they are going to provide and to whom they are going to provide? So basically, the custodian is a person or a group of people who will actually provide a financial custody for basically minor participants, we can say. Say for example, there are minor people who hold assets or stocks in their names, but they are not sure, like until they grow up, until they they want to invest or do something, where their money will be or any kind of asset, how it will be like kept safe. So this custodians basically provide that custody by taking care of their assets. Either it can be in a physical form or in a electronic form. So basically this custodian will be a financial institution or kind of a custodian bank that holds customer securities for safekeeping, because they'll help to prevent it from being lost or being stolen. Okay, so this mostly applies to a case of handling minor accounts. And these custodians, they can actually take care of the assets or the money or whatever be the cash or anything, but they cannot straight away deal with that assets or stocks. They cannot invest it anywhere until unless getting the permission from that actual participant or the account holder. So for that they need to avail the power of attorney. So they can get the power of attorney, and as per that agreement they can utilize that assets or stocks or any cash. They can utilize that and do further investment, and they can generate the revenue. So basically investment advisors are always required to arrange for custodians for their clients. So there are IAs, right, investment advisors. They'll be having their clients, so they'll basically go and check for any custodial services available, and based upon that they will suggest to their clients, and the clients will be picking up accordingly as per their needs. So this is how a custodian works. So next comes this depository. So depository is also a financial institution, we can say. But how it is going to differ from a custodian is, right, this is also kind of place of financial institution or a bank where both major, minor, all set of participants, stocks or assets being handled here. But it is like a depository. So once the holder deposits their assets or stocks or cash or whatever the property they hold here, they get this legal ownership for that. So they straight away deal with investing them further. And whenever The original participant. So who is the owner? The actual owner, whenever they are requesting to get their asset back, the depository has to take chance and they should actually give the asset to the asset or cash or whatever the property they are owning to the owner without any damage. So based upon the request, they have to give back. So basically, if you see custodian and depository, they both are just going to take care of the assets, the overall assets. It can be in any form for various account holders. But for custodian, if you see, investment advisors will be going through for custodial services in search for their clients. Depositories are banks or financial institutions. They directly reach and they directly deal with the owners itself. There are no major or intermediaries. In some cases it will be there, but again, using the money or the asset for their investment, that is like solely decided by the depository itself. But in the case of custodian, they need to get the power of attorney before proceeding anything. So this is how we can, you know, we can just differentiate both of them. And apart from this, the third one, it is like clearing house, they have asked. So clearing house, so everybody should be like, you know, very familiar of this clearing house, because we have seen about our trade and how the trade life cycle goes, everything like that. So clearing means like clearing and settlement of trades, right? So already we discussed in our older videos. So there will be the exchange traded funds are always done traded on exchanges, stock exchanges. So there we'll be having a clearing house who will actually act as a intermediary for clearing and settlement of trades. Because whenever we are doing trade, right, either buyer or either seller, we want to validate them or we want to go through the verification for them whether they are the true participants or the proper appropriate participants for our trade. So who will do that validation? Who will verify them? Who will identify them as the right participant? So the clearing house comes into the picture. So for both buyer and seller, it will act as an intermediary between the buyer and seller, and it will perform the verification or validation, whatever be. So for doing this and taking the risk between both buyer and seller, because anyone might turn out to be default or, you know, fraud in future, but not in all the cases. So for that, they actually charge margin payments. So we all know, right, the margin payments, they need to be paid to the clearing house. So with that charge, they take the risk of being a selling counterpart for a buyer, and for a seller, buying counterpart, you can say, selling counterparty for a buyer, and for a seller, a buyer counterpart. So like simply they will be an intermediary and represent themselves as a seller counterparty for the buyer's side, actual buyer, and for the seller, they will represent them as a buyer counterparty, and they will actually take the risk in execute clearing and settling the trades between them. So we can say like it is like more like a middleman, right? So it's mostly used in futures trading and options trading, where we mostly see that in stock exchanges. So in OTC we won't be able to see those kind, only at stock exchanges like the clearing house comes into picture. So now that we have come up to the end of the video, so clearing house is basically a house which will help us to clear and settle the trades between buyer and seller. Okay, that too, once the trade is being executed between the buyer and seller, then only the clearing house will start its work. for that step please go and watch our trade life cycle. Okay, and a custodian is a kind of a person or a group of people who act as a kind of financial group. They actually work with the investment advisors, advise their clients, like taking care of their assets and stocks and other things. And going beyond that, they get the power of attorney from them and utilize their their assets in further investments and generate revenue. Whereas depository is also kind of financial institution. They also take care of assets of people, but they have the direct legal ownership once the deposits are being deposited into the depository, and they regularly start investing. There is no such restrictions for them. Whenever the client is going to request back for their assets, they have to give it back in the proper condition. So that is the thing. So hope you all got an idea of how the depository, clearing house, custodian, everything works. So the best example in US is DTCC, Depository Trust Clearing Corporation. So this DTCC is providing a clearing house as well as a custodial services as well as depository services across the US clients. So this is a kind of example where they play all the three roles over here. So thanks for watching the video, guys. Hope you all found it interesting. Hope to see you all soon on our next video. Until then, it's your VK signing off. Bye bye.